Good evening from the Big Red Zone, where you will always find more complete coverage of Nebraska football throughout the season. The Huskers practiced for 2 hours this afternoon as they get ready for the Florida Atlantic Owls. Offensive lineman Keith Williams returned to practice today. He set out yesterday with a minor injury. Now, Tuesday is the day for the weekly Husker news conference leading up to each game. The focus wasn't as much on Florida Atlantic this week. Tuesday's talk centered on the Huskers' desire to get on the field after a long preseason camp. It's been 9 months since the Gator Bowl, and the Huskers are ready for a football game.
I feel that we're going to jump on this team because, for me personally, I'm eager to hit somebody other than Ricky Henry every day.
Preseason camp always seems long. Then game day comes around, and not even the veteran players and coaches are sure where they stand.
The first game, I always get nervous. I don't know why. Like, but you know, next game and so on and so forth. The rest of the season, I don't really even have problems. But for some reason, even though I've been going against guys like Sue the whole camp and everything, I'm always convinced that I'm gonna go out there and be terrible. Like, I'm just gonna walk out and not be able to do anything. And I don't know why. It's just this. I guess it's just good old fashioned nerves.
Nebraska head coach Bo Pelini is also concerned about the unknowns. Still, he says he's confident in his team and the mission remains the same.
Day by day, we got to keep getting better. We're not quite ready to play a football game yet, and that's to be expected. Otherwise, we just pack it in and show up on Saturday, and I could go golfing this week. But unfortunately, it is not that way.
No golfing this week for Pelini. Florida Atlantic comes to town for a 6 o'clock game. And that brings us to our Big Red Zone poll question at KETV.com. We're asking, what will the Huskers' record be after the non-conference season? We go from 4-0 to the most pessimistic of predictions. To vote, just go to KETV.com. We'll have the answers for you Thursday night on KETV News Watch 7 at 10.